Patching SQL Server has never been more crucial. Microsoft regularly releases updates in the form of GDRs, which address security issues, and CUs, or community of updates, to address both performance issues and bugs. But as a DBA, you're probably looking towards automation to help you manage that workload and that update cycle. Hi, I'm Luke, and in today's video, we're going to cover the differences between Microsoft Update and Windows Update. We're going to take a quick look at group policy, or GPOs, to ensure updates for software like SQL Server can be delivered through Windows Update or Microsoft Update, a streamlined Ansible playbook that simplifies SQL Server patching that you can use as a basis to build out additional features or tasks inside that playbook. And then stick around to the end. I'll share where you can find additional resources on using Ansible to manage SQL Server on Windows. So I've switched over to my sandbox, and I do have a recent blog post over this topic, and we're going to take a quick look at it. So the first thing is Windows Update versus Microsoft Update, and I really didn't know the difference to this until I put together this post a few weeks ago. So Windows Update, the scope is the default service that provides updates specifically for Windows operating systems. So this is on by default on all Windows operating systems, and it already includes security patches, bug fixes, driver updates, and feature updates. But the primary focus is on the operating system itself. Microsoft Update, which is an extension of Windows Update, provides updates for not only the Windows operating system, but also other Microsoft products such as Microsoft Office, SQL Server, Exchange, Visual Studio, and other Microsoft software. The focus is broader scope, covering a range of Microsoft products just beyond the operating system. And this isn't enabled by default. So if it's not enabled, you're using Windows Update on your Windows servers, and you won't be able to use Windows Update to download the patches for SQL Server. So that's going to be our first step today, is to take a look at a group policy, which I know typically a DBA won't have access to look at group policy, but here in our sandbox, we can take a look at that just real quick. So I'm going to go ahead and switch over to DC1, which is my domain controller in my sandbox. And I have a group policy management editor opened. And we're going to go under computer configuration, administrative templates. And before I get too far, I'm going to go ahead and enable cursor so you can see it. Here we go. So we're going to expand Windows components. And we're going to scroll down all the way down to Windows Update. Configure automatic updates will need to be enabled. However, we don't want those updates to go ahead and install automatically for SQL Server. We want to set aside usually a maintenance window where the DBA does the patching. So in here, we want to make sure that this setting is enabled. And then we want to configure automatic updating for notify for download and auto install. That's incorrect. We want to allow local admin to choose the setting. So we choose 5, and then just every week install. The important thing is to make sure that this install updates for other Microsoft products is checked. So what that does is it's going to enable Microsoft updates on the servers where this GPO is applied to. We're going to go ahead and click OK. And now we're going to switch back over to SRV2. So we're going to be patching 2 servers today, SRV2 and SRV1. And we'll go ahead and go down to the search. These are both Windows Server 2022 servers. And we're just going to jump into Windows Update settings. And we can see here at the top, some settings are managed by your organization. We can go ahead and click on View Policies. And we can see that the policy set on your device, Get Updates for Other Microsoft Products, is enabled. So we know that we're using Microsoft Update on this system. Same for SRV1, which is another SQL Server. We'll go ahead and take a look at Windows Update here. look at the policy, and we know that that GPO has been applied to get updates for other Microsoft products. Go ahead and close out of here. Now I'm going to jump over to SRV3, which is where I have Windows Subsystem for Linux installed, and then in WSL, I have an Ubuntu machine with Ansible installed. So this is going to be our playbook that we run. It's a very simple playbook. The name is just going to be Windows Updates. The host is SQL Servers, which is my SQL Server group inside of my host.ini file. And we're going to be patching these two servers here, SRV1 and SRV2. Go ahead and switch back over to Windows Patching. You'll see links to this playbook in the blog post I just had up. With this playbook, we have one task defined. I've just named the task Install Updates, and we're going to be using Ansible's built-in Windows module Win Updates, which allows us to do a server selection. So server selection allows you to either use a Windows Server Update Services server if it's configured in your environment, or you can have it go out to Windows Update at Microsoft and download the updates from there. That's what we're going to choose today by using the default. The state is installed. We want to make sure that the update that we define is installed on our host machines. The category names is Microsoft SQL Server 2022. This is the only update that we're going to install. You can install multiple updates. And then the accept list, this is going to make sure that we only install this one update. So KB5038325, which corresponds to, I like to use this site, sqlserverbuilds.blogspot.com. Whoever runs this site keeps it up to date, and it's usually got the latest information. So this is the CU we're going to install today is CU14, and we know that by that KB number. So KB5038325. We know we're going to reach out to Microsoft and download this patch and then install it on our host machines. So let's go ahead and take a quick look at our current build version. So we're 4131 on SRV2 and the same on SRV1. 4131, that build version corresponds to CU13. So when we're finished, we should see this build in SQL Server Management Studio. Let's go ahead and jump into WSL. And I've already changed my directory to where that I have that playbook installed or playbook saved. We're going to run Ansible-playbook, provide the playbook name, which is Playbook Windows Patching. Should probably rename that to SQL Server Patching, but we can expand on that. We're going to provide my domain credentials. And we're going to have Ansible ask us for the password. Real quick, I do want to show these last two settings, log path, you'll see cansible_w.txt. That's where we're going to write out any information about the updates that we find. And then we want to go ahead and reboot the server if needed. So reboot true. All right, let's jump back and we're going to go ahead and press enter. And by default, Ansible will gather facts on the remote machines. And so we know that we were able to successfully connect to both of those hosts, and now we're going to install the updates. So if we jump over to SRV2, you'll see that we now have Ansible_W, which is our Windows Update log file, and the same thing on SRV1. And see, Ansible is, our Windows Update is writing out information to that log file, and we can see that CU14 was found. So it's going to go ahead and download it and install. Now, again, this is a very simplified Ansible playbook. There are other methods that you can use to automatically install updates. This one specifically uses Windows Update to install a SQL Server patch. You can use tools like DBA tools, and you can also build onto your Ansible playbooks to where it's more advanced. In a production case, you may want to make sure that you've ran backups. Go ahead. This will take just a few minutes, and it's actually, we can see that it's doing something by jumping into Task Manager. Go ahead and expand that, and we should see Scenario Engine running. So that's the actual executable that's running and patching. Same thing here on SRV1. And you can also see Hotfix Pack Scenario Engine there. So we'll let this run for a few minutes, and then we'll take another look. All right, we can see that Ansible reported there was a change on SRV1. If we jump over there, we should see SRV1 restart if it's required. I don't think it was required. Let's go and check our builds, as both of them have completed. No errors, nothing failed. So let's take a look at our build numbers. So we can see that that changed from 4131 to 4135. And 4135 on SRV1. So both of those look good. We can jump into SQL Server logs and just take a look to make sure that there's no errors. Go ahead and take a quick look through our log. And here we can see we're running that RTM CU14, so that confirms we're on the right version. There's our KB 503-8325, and then our build here again. And SRV1's the same. So there you have it. Real quick, simplified Ansible playbook that we used Windows Update, or actually Microsoft Update, to reach out, pull down the patch, and then install into SQL Server instances. Again, if you like more information on Ansible and managing SQL Server on Windows, be sure to check out the playlist that I have, Ansible for SQL Server DBAs. And I also invite you to sign up for my DBA Challenges newsletter, which you'll find at just www.dbachallenges.com. Each week, I'm releasing a new challenge. Usually, that challenge takes less than 8 hours to complete, but it's just created so that you as a DBA can get additional hands-on experience. Maybe there's some things that you don't have access to in your work environment that you could build out an environment at home and kind of work through to gain that experience. So again, thanks a lot for sticking around, and I'll see you in the next video.